We're going to learn about modules in this video, and I want to make this video on modules because there's a lot of confusion out there about how to use modules and the different things to do, and we're going to work with a couple of different code bases to do this. You can see here I'm at GitHub goes to 11, and I have some repositories over here. I'm putting together a new code base for the third version of my Learn to Code Go course. That's right here. We're going to be working out of that code base. And we're going to be working out of 000, modules, 01. And that's just by chance where it came up. And we're also going to be pulling in dependencies. So we're going to learn about modules and dependencies and versioning all really quick right here. We're going to be pulling in dependencies from this puppy repo. And so if we open this puppy repo, we can look at the code. We're also going to pull in dependencies from the dog repo, which will be indirect dependencies. So we're going to learn about Go mod, modules, dependency management, all of that. And we're going to see that in this video. So if we look at puppy.go right here, puppy.go pulls in code from package dog. And so the package dog code that it pulls in is it gets when grown up. And then we pass in this function bark. So here's bark, it returns a string. And when grown up, if we look at the code on when grown up in the dog package, when grown up takes in a string, returns a string, and it says when the puppy grows up, it says, and strings to upper, and then it capitalizes whatever we passed in. So if bark returns the string of woof, it capitalizes woof. And so we're gonna use puppy, the package puppy in our code. That's gonna be a direct dependency. Our code is going to directly depend upon the code in puppy to work. And when you're dealing with dependencies, you wanna read Russ Cox, our dependency problem right here, right? And our software dependency problem, super important document to read, so make sure you check that out. But anyhow, our code's gonna directly depend upon puppy. And then since puppy uses dog, right? Puppy uses dog, our code's gonna indirectly depend upon dog. And we're gonna see that in our Go mod file. Here's the first thing you need to know about Go modules in Go. Anytime you wanna write Go code. So I'm just gonna go here to my terminal and I guess I'm gonna lose my place here and go up to documents. So go up one, two, now I'm in documents. And you can see I'm in documents. And if I list what's in documents there, I do not currently have a temp file. So I'm gonna make a directory. I'm gonna make this temp. And I'm gonna cd into that directory. Common error on my part is to not cd into that directory. And then once I'm in this directory, I'm gonna take a look what's in there. If I want to write Go code in this directory, right? I need a Go module. So I can do go mod init. And this will initialize this directory. And I need some namespace here, right? This will initialize this directory as a place where I can write Go code. And then this is like the old way you had to deal with environment variables and the go path variable, but now you just do this go mod init in any directory where you want to write go code. It creates this go.mod file for you right here. And then that file means, hey, you could start writing go code in this folder and go is going to do its magic in the background to make sure everything's taken care of, all your packages are tracked and all of that. So your namespace there, your namespace can be anything. I could call this my module. Or, you know, if this is going to be a package that I want to be accessible to other people or to myself, I'd give it a domain, a username, and goes to 11. And if you want to know why goes to 11, go YouTube goes to 11, Rob Reiner, Spinal Tap. So github.com goes to 11, and then I'd do some name. So if this was going to be a package cat, right? I would have a repo called cat, and that's where that repo would live. And this is the namespace. It's the space defined by a name where this code lives. It's the namespace. No other code in the world, no other package in the world could exist because this domain is unique. This username is unique, and this repo is unique. So no other, you know, namespace in the world could hold this code. But for this example, I'm just going to call this my module. So you could call this whatever you want. And you could call it my module or L module. I'm going to call it L module. La modula. La modula. That's what I'm going to call it. And so, you know, I do that and it creates a place where I can now write Go code. And you can see that go.mod file there. And if I cat that, right, it's going to show me that all it's in there is my module is called La Modula, and it's Go 1.20, which is what I'm using. I'm going to cd out of this, and I'm going to remove recursively with force my temp directory, because I don't need that. I'm going to cd back into learn to code version 3 in the 000.aw, and that's where we're going to be working. So if I want to come back to this terminal, I could do it. Sweet. That's the first thing you need to know about Go modules is Go mod init. All right, so the next thing you'll know is that you can have dependencies. Here, I've already used this repo puppy in an example. And so I'm requiring puppy version 1.3.0. If we go to GitHub and we look at puppy, let's look at it. I'm gonna go to code puppy. And here in code puppy, I click on the tags. I've got three versions, right? I've got three versions right there. And so I could use any of those. I could require here any one of those versions that I want. So if I wanted to change what version that I had there, I could go get, and I could go get that repo. And so I'm gonna get the name up here, bop, 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 bop. And I could say, hey, let's go get that repo. And then I could say, I want a certain version. And I could put that version here. Maybe I want at v1.2.0. And I go get version 1.2.0. Now I'm using the code base as it existed at version 1.2.0. That's really good, because if you're depending, your code's depending upon some other code, and then they upgrade and it breaks your code, you could say, well, go back to their previous version and let's get that, let's use that until our code gets working. And then if I want to go back to the most recent version, I could change this and I could say, you know, version 1.3, or I could do latest, like this, and they'll grab the latest. I have found one time latest didn't work, and so I had to force it, and force it by pushing the version number. You could also come into the commits. You could come into the commits, you could get the commit hash right here, and you could put that hash after this at symbol, and it'll force that one version. And because we're using puppy, our indirect dependency is dog. And so you saw how that works. And so in here in the code base, I'm not gonna write the code for you, actually. I'm just gonna come in here and look for that that example that I already wrote, so I don't waste your time just sitting there typing out code. Hold on 1 second while I find it. All right, so here's the code, and the code is 047 in this code base, mod code depend 02. And you can see the code here is, I'm in this repo, and the repo is this repo right here, which is learn to code Go version 3. And in learn to code Go version 3, I'm in 047, which is 047 right there, which is that. And so code dependency 02, and I'm using puppy package, and there's puppy package, and I'm using puppy package, but puppy package also depends upon the dog package. And so that's why in my mod file, I have these dependencies listed right there. So that's the code, so you don't have to sit here and watch me type out these little things. And that's how you go get dependencies and get dependencies of different versions and go get packages so that you could use third-party packages in your code. Read that article by Russ Cox. And then the last thing I want to say is that two things. One, I'm going to show you versions, but also this code's amazing, understanding control flow. So if you're just getting with going with the Go programming language, you could check that out. And then also if you're just getting going with the Go programming language, you could go to mcleods.com and you could take all of the video lectures that are associated with all of this code right here. So it's all explained to you thoroughly, efficiently, and in a fun way. All right, so that's that one. And now I just wanna show you versions. And so to show you versions, so how do we tag things with versions? So here I am in this main.go, and I'm just gonna do a simple little program here. I'm gonna do func main, and in func main, I'm gonna type, what am I gonna type? I'm gonna do func.println, and in the func.println, I'm gonna say, I hope this was valuable for you. Because, like, you know, I looked around at the different resources that are out there for explaining dependency management and Go modules, and I was like, come on, people. And I haven't had the good fortune recently of teaching Go at the college or the university, just because I'm not always in charge of what gets scheduled, and that's kind of bummed me out. So it's been a bit since I've been able to teach Go and make videos. But when I saw that this video needed to be made, I was like, I'm going to make it. Maybe I'll keep making more videos. All right, so here we go. And I also want to say, if you liked this, right, like and subscribe, because if you do that, and it actually just motivates me. I'm like, okay, there's like, you know, X thousands of people who could benefit from a video I'm going to make. It motivates me to make those videos. All right, so that was that. Last thing I want to show you here is I'm going to clear out at my terminal, and I'm going to do a git tag. And so there are my tags currently. And to do this, I guess I'm going to come over to this terminal. I'm going to do a git tag. And so for this learn to code Go version 3 course, I have these tags already. And if you come over here to GitHub and you look at the different versions, the different tags, I have 1.6.1 is my most recent. And so to tag versions so that when you have a version of code that you want to use as a dependency, you could specify exactly which version you want to tag your versions. This is how you do it with Git. So first, git tag shows you all of your tags, right? And then clear that. And then I'll leave it at the top, actually, so we could see it increment. And then I'm going to do git tag, and then you tag just like what version you want. I'm going to call this 1.7.0. And then I'm going to do git push origin dash. I always have to think about this just a little bit. Git push origin tags. And then I could do git tag again. And I've got 161 went to 170, right? And you can learn all about semantic versioning and all of that in the course also. Or you could Google it in my course also. Or you could Google it. My course is at mclouds.com. And so the last thing I want to say is if we come here and we refresh this, we could then see here in our tags, we have tag version 170. We could click on any of these to see the code base in that version, what this code base state was in that version. And we could also call these versions, different states of the code base into our Go programs using Go Git and then specifying the version that we want to get. So that is my take on Go modules, dependency management, and versioning. Woo! Hope you enjoyed it.